the wrong course, or they have seen idea or ideal of marriage, and they see that that's not working for them. So I just wanted to tell you a little bit about before I got married. I used to be in relationships a lot, and I was always afraid of being the one that was going to be hurt. So I would always excuse me, do something that would cause the relationship to fail. I was just afraid, I guess, because in the house that I grew up in, I didn't want relationships. I didn't want mine to be like that. I don't know why that was, but I had a fear of relationships. So anyone that would come close to me, I would find a reason to break it off, or either to run. Even once I got married, I was still doing the same thing. Thank you. I was still doing the same thing. My husband had a surgery a couple years ago, actually about 3 years ago. I was not where I needed to be with God. I was where I wanted to be in marriage, but not where I wanted to, where I needed to be in God, where it would glorify God in the times that I didn't feel appreciated in my marriage, or I didn't feel like I was getting what I'm supposed to be getting, because I had been looking at the world standards of marriage. And I grew up with Leave It to Beaver, where everything was perfect in that household. Even the mother would dress for dinner. She would wake up, seem like she had pearls around her neck. And I grew up with that, which was not reality. Excuse me. And as I matured, I started asking God, how does he want me to deal with this? And it's not like I had to deal with it. I felt like I had to deal with it because I was in it. So I felt like I had to take control of this. I was getting angry all the time at my husband for him just being my husband, or just being a man, or anything he would say. I would just get so upset. I'm telling myself, I don't have to put up with this. I even do that now, but not like I used to. And this is just a testimony for someone that's listening. I had to learn to be submissive to my husband. And people now don't want to hear that word, especially women. But you have to. Any relationship, you have to back down sometimes. When you feel like you want to beat him in the head or anything like that, just start talking to God immediately before your hands start being raised to that person, or thoughts start flooding your mind as to what you feel you need to be doing. Just hear God, because everything that God takes you to, he will take you through it. And you're not just going to run through and not get anything out of it. You're going to learn something in the process. I was reading a scripture this morning that God had given me, and it was about the water being turned to wine. Before I read that, I'm going to say that's what happened to me. I was poured in to this situation with my husband, and I know it was for God's glory. And I know that this man is to be my husband, even though I tried to talk myself out of it many times. I listened to people, why don't you just leave him? You don't have to put up with this. And that's what people do too many times. You're listening to other people that have no reason in your business at all. And we allow them to come in because we tell them everything that's going on in our relationships. And that's another thing we shouldn't be doing. That's none of their business. They're having problems keeping their own relationships together, and then they want to give you advice. That's why the Bible is telling you to keep your eye on yourself, not on somebody else. So while he was doing, pouring me in more and more engaged in this relationship, excuse me, I didn't feel like this was the right partner for me. I also didn't feel like I'm ready to be married. I didn't even feel like I was ready to be a mother. I'm like, this can't be my child. You know, who did this child come from? I really was feeling that. And when I got married, I felt the same way. I'm too young to get married. I felt all the insecurities that I shouldn't have been feeling. But God, through it all, the water that he was pouring into the barrel, when he poured it out, it was wine. I was transformed over the years, and I know this was God. And even God is working in my husband, even now. It's just amazing to watch. People don't like to say they're sorry. For whatever reason, it's a word. I'm sorry. I don't have a problem saying it anymore. I used to be so bullheaded. I know that's really hard to believe. But, but I used to be so bullheaded as to, I'm not going to let him have his way. But, you know, when God is pressing you like grapes, pressing all the juice out, whew, he's pressing out all the impurities. And that is good in marriage and in attitudes, in any relationship. He's pressing the impurities out because he's calling us together. And I don't know any other way to express it except he turned this water into wine. And only God could do that, because now I'm telling people about it, whereas when I was going through it, I couldn't say a word. When people would say, how's your husband? All I would say, mm-hmm. That was it. I didn't have anything good to say. But now it's like, oh, I thank you, Lord, for this man. I thank you for him being my husband. And I would have left him. I would have done a whole lot of other things. But God said, no. Watch me work in you. And then while I'm working in you, I'm also working in him. Now, again, I know this is God that's coming out of me, because I hadn't planned to say this. I had something else that I thought that I should say, but God said, no, say this. Someone is struggling. Many people are struggling in marriage because it's so easy to get out of now. It's no more commitment in reference to marriage or anything else. People start things and they're ready to stop. They don't want to go to the full length of it. They don't want to go to the finish line. And that's with anything. But marriage is sacred. It's not for you to get in and just as an escape route to be able to leave your home. And that's what I thought it was as well. I said, well, if I marry this man, I can get out of living at home. Because as being younger, you're always rebellious. I was a rebellious teenager. Thank you. Thank you so much. Excuse me. I was rebellious in every way possible. I ran away from home many times. I don't know what all that stemmed from. I do not know. But God knew the root of the problem. And as I got older and started to trust him more, he started to do incredible things in me. So that now I can stand in front of you and just tell you it's going to work out. But you got to be willing to go forth with God. Let him lead you. Not get upset. People with bad, nasty attitudes, they're like popcorn. All you have to do is say one word and they have terrible attitudes. We have to hear God. And excuse me, and in John 2, one through 10, it says, on the third day, a wedding took place at Cana in Galilee. Jesus' mother was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine was gone, Jesus' mother said to him, they have no more wine. Woman, why do you involve me? Jesus replied, my hour has not yet come. And that's how we feel a lot of times, that we're not supposed to be doing this because someone else can do it. This is not my time to do this or that. And that's what I was thinking about marriage. You know, I'm not supposed to be married, but I felt like I had to do that in order to get freedom from something. Now, coming down a little bit further, says, my hour has not yet come. His mother said to the servants, do whatever he tells you to do. Now, we're going to come down a little bit further, and it says, fill the jars with water. That's what God was commanding them because they had no more wine. So he's telling them, fill these jars. And they each jar contained like 20 to 30 gallons. That's a lot of water. Fill these jars with water so that they filled each barrel to the brim. Then he told them, now draw out and take it to the master of the banquet. And that's us. We're being poured in as water, as something that really, I mean, water is nourishment to our bodies. Any kind of water, it could be spring water, distilled, tap water, cold water, warm water. That's nourishment to our body. But it's not the main ingredient. It doesn't have a flavor, no taste. It doesn't, it has nothing. But when God gets finished with you, when you finish going through your tests, and there are going to be many, when you get finished going through your trials, you're not going to come out just as water anymore. You're going to have nourishment. You're going to have flavor. You're going to have color. Oh, wine. New wine is what you will become. New wine that will help you to not only help your mate or someone else, but the world will see the transformation. They'll see once you went in, you're not coming out the same way. Recently, I had an awesome opportunity to go on to the Oasis of the Seas. Before I left from Pennsylvania, I had 20 things going on wrong with me, physically, spiritually. I was so pressed down. Once we set sail out to sea, I could just feel them start falling off of me. And that was amazing because it was a task trying to get forward. And people need to realize when things start coming at you fast, 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 God is getting ready to bless you. God is getting ready to do something so incredible, so supernatural that you couldn't have done it. But only your faith is what gets you to that point. And I could feel them just being broken off little by little, like it was just a release, like an anchor just being snipped from my ankles. That's how I felt. So I left all of that junk out to sea. But when I hit land, God did something different in me. He wanted to empty me out first so that he can refill me with what he had planned for me all along, which I was too stubborn and bullheaded to receive because I was too overwhelmed with life. It's a magnificent thing when you can see that only God could have done it. When I got back, I learned that I didn't have to pray about everything. I was stepping into faith more with less words, with less crying out to God, because I left all the stuff behind that was keeping me from going higher in God. Now, I'm seeing when things are coming at me, and they are still coming at me. I'm not saying that nothing is happening now. They're still coming at me, but I'm approaching it a whole lot different than what I did when I left to go on to this cruise. So I'm saying God has now made me into wine, something only he could have done supernaturally. We might go in one way, but when we pour it out, we're coming out a different way. Major transformation, supernatural, extraordinary. So whatever it is you're going through, and you will go through, and you will come out, but just know it's not going to be the same when you come out. Anytime you go, that's like going through school. You go from first grade to maybe eighth grade. Each grade, you go a little higher. It's the same with God. We get so comfortable with where we are in God, but God's telling us, I got something higher for you. I got another level for you. Are you willing to go forth with me and just lay down yourself? And even coming here today, I was just just talking to God and telling him, I want more of you, Lord. More of you where I can't even see me anymore. And he's doing that with faith, with faith. And what I'm noticing, people that are calling themselves Christians, now I'm not saying it's about everybody, but there are too many carnal Christians that want to stay hooked up to the world and do what the world is doing. I don't have those desires anymore. I did when I was going through the motions. When I first got married, I was just going through the motions. My mother taught me how to be a good wife, not by anything that she was saying, but it was by me watching her. I saw how she treated my dad, and I couldn't understand it. I couldn't understand why he always had the biggest piece of chicken. And the rest of us, we love the chicken, but we got the wing, the leg, but he always got the biggest piece of chicken. And I do that with my husband. I always want to give him the best because I love hard. I am not a person that would just love just a little bit. How can you love a little bit? When you love, it's all out there. It's coming from you to the other person or to whatever it is you're putting yourself into. And I just thank God that he has brought me this far. Because without him, I can say many times, I wouldn't have made it to this part. At least not in the state of mind that I am in now. And I'm grateful because we all have a testimony. We might not want to share it. And I have a whole lot of other testimonies that it's not time for those to come out yet. This one, God wanted to come out in reference to marriage, in reference to letting God do what he needs to do in you instead of you trying to force the issue. I remember many times it wasn't harmonious in my household. And the least little thing my husband would do, I'm standing there at the sink just thinking about all the things I could say to him to get back at him, what I could go in there and do. And it's like, but God would never let me do that. Huh. And, you know, I'm saying even now when I get that feeling that's coming up on me, I just start talking to God. And before I'm done in the kitchen, I can hear my husband calling from the other room. Baby, are you okay? Wow, God. That wouldn't have happened years ago. And that wouldn't have happened if I submitted to my way. And then when I get to him, he's saying, I'm sorry. And me too. And it's like nothing ever happened. It's just like the biggest reunion at that time because we both humbled ourselves. And that's what God expects us to humble to one another, and especially to God. God is bigger than us, but yet and still, we take it all on us. A person told me while we were on the cruise that I internalize a lot instead of bringing things out into the open. Like, some people have such a sharp tongue, as soon as you say something to them, they can come back at you with whatever they need to say. I've never been that person. I have to think about it. And once I'm done thinking, it's weeks later. You know, and God has fixed it. You know, I thought that was a curse, that I wouldn't be able to respond to people. But God has made me see it's a blessing that I'm not that sharp-tongued person. Mighty God, thank you for the lessons, Lord, because that's what they are. They're life lessons that we must learn to be able to help others, because there's so many people doing things wrong. They're trying to get out of stuff. So many hurting people. But we got joy. We got joy in us that can help bring them out. And I'm learning that more and more. We might be water, but God is turning us into wine. He's pressing those grapes. That's what he's doing with me. And anyone that stands up here is not perfect. We might appear to be perfect, but we're not. We have lots of things that are going on in our lives, just like all of you do. All of you have issues. We have issues. And I just thank God that the issues that we have, they're not the way they used to be. the changes that I see in myself, it's so phenomenal. I would have never imagined that I would be standing up here. I would never imagine, how in the world am I to even tell anybody anything else? Who am I? Who am I? I am the one that God chose, just like you. And in order to bring my husband closer to God, I had to be God's representative. If he always saw me angry, how was that going to draw him in to God? And especially if he's, this is another thing, if he's seeing me going out ministering, or if I'm praying with people on the phone, and then in our relationship, it's so much hell going on. How is, that's confusing. Because sometimes people automatically have a bad attitude about people that go to church or have a relationship with God. They want to twist it so that it, in other words, in their minds, you're just as bad as anybody else, in other words. They always say it's hypocrites in churches. Hypocrites everywhere. Not just in church, but you just don't expect to see them in church. But God, he has made a way out of no way for me. My marriage is growing and getting better and better. Only God could have done it. Just hold on. Let God do what God needs to do. Maybe he's trying to shake you up. I always say trying, but God's not trying to do anything. He does it. God is shaking you up, waking you up to see him, not your problem. Because when you're focusing on your problem, it's still a problem. It's just a bigger problem. But once you take your eyes off that problem, you're giving it to God. I know you all have heard me talking about my son a lot. I have given him to God. And any other issues, I have just given it to God since I've come back on land, that all those burdens have lifted. And I feel this freedom. I'm sleeping all night long, which is a blessing. Before I left, I had memory problems. I had trying to see problems. I had pains in my legs, all in my body. I was full of infections, one here, one there, but I would never tell anybody. When I came back, I left it out to sea. I have none of that now. I was pressed down. I was pressed down. I just thank God. You don't know freedom until you've been in prison. Ha! Mighty God. Yes, Lord. Anybody that's listening, any one of you that's listening, that feel like you're bound, there's no way out, there is. He is the Savior, the Christ. Just call on him. Just call on him. Just call on his name. Just tell him, Lord, I'm sorry. I repent of the ways that I've had, what I've done. And that's what we need to say to one another again. Sorry, sorry. Forgive me, forgive me. Lift one another up. Not press people down. Nobody wants to say, you look good. You've done a good job. They don't want to say that anymore. And God has called us to lift up one another. Wow. If someone's sick, call them. Or send them a card. It means so much. Especially when you're underappreciated. And you feel that. You feel that no one appreciates you, no matter how much you're pressing forward to do all you can for this person. And then God's puts you on someone's heart. And a beautiful card comes in the mail. It's amazing. It's like, Lord, I thank you. You had me on your mind. Because only you could have done this. Lord, thank you. Call on God. He's your Savior. Say that you want him to be your Savior. Just give him your all, because the more you give to him, the more he takes away from you. The lighter you feel, and you will get stressed. I don't want to use that word stress, because that's how I got to where I was. I kept saying, I'm stressed, I'm stressed, I'm stressed. So I got stressed and more stressed, and then it was getting bigger and bigger. It was just like pouring water onto something, and it just kept overflowing, and I saw no way out. But God said, I am the comforter. I'm your comforter. I am the way, the truth, and the life. and none of this other stuff matters. He says, peace I say unto you. And I know peace now. I know peace. I used to have it all up here, the scriptures for peace, but it wasn't right here. It was not in my heart. But it is now. When things start attacking me and coming at me, I'm like, okay, God, you know all about this. Thank you. I'm giving it to you, and I'm gone. I don't even think about it anymore. And I remember while we were away, God said he's calling us to belief, not just reciting scriptures. We have to believe it now, because it was something that we needed to do while we were on the ship. And I was supposed to tell my roommate, just believe that I will answer it. They couldn't understand that because we're so religious. We want to do it XYZ way instead of just believe it. Just believe that he sees all of this that's going on. Just believe that I'm going to answer it. You just gave it to me, so expect an answer. So God, I thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I also feel I need to pray for healing for someone. So Father, you are God. You are God. And I, in the name of Jesus, I come against every bit of sickness, every bit of ill health, disease. I'm feeling something in like the leg, the lower portion. Lord, I'm speaking to that right now to move right on out. Nothing but peace, peace, peace and healing right in the lower part of their body, right up in the thigh areas. Lord, I thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for opening them up to see you even more. Lord, just reveal yourself more to them. Lord, we thank you for it all. In Jesus' precious name, woo! In Jesus' name, glorious to God, glorious God. Amen.